Hello everyone, welcome back to Sonika's History class. So what we will be studying today, here we will see the strange case of Britain or the unification of Britain or why it is called Great Britain, why it is called United Kingdoms, okay, why it is called England. So all this we will see. Many a time children get confused, ma'am, it is either whether it is England or it is UK, why it is called, why there are so many names for this region, okay. So today it will be cleared in this video. Let us get started. I hope you have seen the last video, the unification of Italy. This is the third topic in your book, the unification of Britain or the strange case of Britain or why it is said that the unification of Britain was a strange case. Because the formation of Britain was result of long process. Other two unifications which we have seen till now, Germany and Italy, the unification process occurred or between 10-20 years only, right? Even it can be less than that. But here, in the case of Britain, it was very long process, we will see here. Britain was not a nation before 18th century. It was an island which was inhabited by ethnic groups, different ethnic groups such as English, Wales, Scots and Irish. Okay, so the country England which we see today, before 18th century, it was you can say occupied by different ethnic groups who spoke different languages. These groups had their own culture and political traditions. They followed different cultures and political traditions means types of governments, monarchies or dictatorships or constitutional monarchy, okay, or parliamentary government. So whatever was there, their tradition, political traditions were also different from each other. As English started growing wealthy and gaining power, English people started growing wealthy and gaining power and importance. They started extending their influence over the other nations of the island. Okay, so now English people, they started becoming wealthy and they became more powerful. Political power they gained more and more. So now once they became powerful and rich, they started extending their influence on the other nations of the island. Okay, so first let us just see again the geographical division of England. This part was Scotland. This was before unification was England and this is Northern Ireland. Okay, Wales, this is Wales. These different parts will be unified into one nation which will be then calling Great Britain. Okay, so now there the people of Scotland who spoke Scottish language. Now Ireland was otherwise one nation, but there was you can say differences between people on the basis of religion. Here it was dominated by Protestants and this southern part was dominated by the Catholics. Okay, then this was English people dominated, then Wales, then Scotland. Okay, this was all. Now let us start with the main part. The English Parliament seized power from the monarchy in 1688 after a conflict. Now English Parliament means in England the parliament, there was king as well as there was a parliament. Okay, so the English Parliament seized power from monarchy in 1868 after a conflict. They had a conflict and parliament declared themselves independent from monarchy. Okay, so they seized power. English people, they became powerful now. Now they were not under monarchy. Finally, a nation state was formed with England as its center. Okay, so as England we have seen here. Okay, so it was also previously there were different kings, but now English Parliament seized power. So this was declared as nation state with England as its center. Okay, so this much place was unified in 1688. Finally, a nation state was formed. Okay, so that conflict arose in 1688, but then it was England was declared as a nation state as its center. Now in 1707, another political incident took place. It was the Act of Union came into being between England and Scotland. Now Scotland you have seen in map here. This is Scotland, this was England here. स्कॉटलैंड वॉज इफ वी सी इन दोज ईयर्स इन 17th और 18th सेंचुरी इट वॉज वेरी पुअर रीजन ओके स्कॉटलैंड वॉज वेरी पुअर एंड ऑल्सो बैकवर्ड मोस्ट ऑफ द पीपल ऑफ स्कॉटलैंड देवर एग्रीकल्चरलिस्ट ओके एंड इट वॉज वेरी बैकवर्ड रीजन बिकॉज ऑफ इट्स इकोनॉमिक डिफेंस क्राइसिस ओनली और बिकॉज ऑफ इकोनॉमिक प्रॉब्लम इट हैड टू साइन द एक्ट ऑफ यूनियन इन 1707 दिस एक्ट ऑफ यूनियन हैड ग्रेट रोल टू प्ले इन दिस मोस्ट ऑफ द यू कैन से प्रोविजन्स ऑफ एक्ट ऑफ यूनियन दे वर ओनली इकोनॉमिक टाइज ओके सी एक्ट ऑफ यूनियन हियर इन डिटेल इट इज नॉट गिवन इन योर बुक्स दिस दे हैव सेड एक एक्ट ऑफ यूनियन द स्कॉटिश पार्लियामेंट वोटेड ऑन 6 January 1707 दिस वॉज द डेट एंड मंथ by 110-269 to adopt the treaty of union which is called the act of union it was a full economic union okay so by this act by passing this act england will give economic protection to scotland which it needed that time very badly indeed most of its 25 articles it means in that act there were 25 articles they dealt with economic arrangements for the new state known as great britain Now first it was England only. England and Scotland was in north, but now we are seeing Great Britain. How it got its name? It was that it added 45 Scots. It was first. Let us understand what happened. Now England said to the people of Scotland that England will help them in economic areas. Okay, England will provide economic protection to Scotland, but in the same time, in return. It will get unified or in you can say it will merge within England okay and the state which will come into existence now with the merging of Scotland with England will be called Great Britain now Wales it was already taken okay before Scotland's unification with England Wales was already taken up before that much before that okay so this was the act of union that great britain will be formed with the unifying both scotland and england okay so but many of the terms of act of union were very you can say full of partiality against scotland people it added 45 scots to 513 members of the house of commons these are details actually not necessary for writing answers in your exams and not given in your textbook as well but just for general knowledge you must know that how people of Scottish people were treated okay so in the house of commons as we say in india we have lok sabha okay so there in england in great britain now we have to say there were 513 members so now 45 will be out of 513 45 will be Scottish people how less you can see the proportion then in house of lords as we have Rajya Sabha in center there were 190 member and out of 190 16 will be Scots okay so and ended the Scottish parliament so Scotland also had its own parliament but that parliament came to an end now because it did not have any other separate government now it was now the part of England only right so England and Scotland together came to be called as Great Britain okay I hope why it was called Great Britain it is clear to you now it also replaced the Scottish system of currency taxation and laws regulating trade with laws were now made in London okay so all the legal system or the currency system taxes system of Scotland that also all was replaced by their all now English everything was now dominated by or everything was made by in London now England had about 5 times the population of Scotland at the same time about 36 times much wealth okay England was more powerful than Scotland 5 times more population and 36 times more wealth okay and the major reason behind signing the act of union for Scotland was economic problems or you can say economic depression Scots were very poor they did not have any good trade relations also with any country because they did not have anything to trade or export from themselves okay so they found this act to be, you can say, very beneficial for them. Okay, so this is what the Act of Union was. So this resulted in the formation of United Kingdom of Great Britain. Soon England imposed its influence on Scotland. Even the British Parliament was dominated by the English members. Okay, that we have already seen. I have shown you that the Scottish people were very less there. Later on, the culture and political institutions of Scotland were suppressed by growing British power. Now, the culture of Scotland and the political institutions of Scotland were also suppressed, and English power was dominating. For example, Scottish was forced to not speak in their Gaelic language. This was the language of Scotland, regional language. But now Scottish people, after being a part of, you can say, Great Britain, they were not allowed to speak their own language and wear their national dress. Okay, so large number of Highlanders were forcibly driven out of their homeland also. Many people, they were sent out of their homeland also, Highlanders. Ireland also had a similar story. Ireland, I showed you in map. Let us see once again. Ireland here. It had different story. Ireland, actually, it was first, it was one kingdom only. Ireland like this. But it had region, you can say, conflicts between people on the basis of religion. That also was one of the strategy of Britain only. This country was divided between Catholics and Protestants. England helped the Protestants of Ireland, and this resulted in the dominance of Protestants over Catholics. Now, Catholics and Protestants, they raised conflicts among themselves. England again interfered there, and it helped the Protestants. Okay, so now the Protestants became more powerful in Ireland over the Catholics. So there were revolts, violent revolts in Ireland. The revolts led by Catholics were suppressed by British dominance. The revolts which were started by Catholics against the Protestant dominant, it was all suppressed by the British. Now, Wolfe Tone, who was leading Irish revolutionary, who formed a group named as United Irishmen. He revolted against English supremacy, but later on, this revolt was also suppressed by the English in 1798. Okay, as we have read about different nationalist leaders, we have read in Germany, Italy, Giuseppe Garibaldi, Giuseppe Mazzini, then we read Keble, Chief Minister, okay, different people. So here, in Ireland, one person named as Wolfe Tone, he was leading Irish revolutionary who formed a group named as United Irishmen against the growing English influence or the influence of England in Ireland. Okay, he revolted against the English supremacy, but this revolt was suppressed by English in 1798. Because England that time, it became more powerful by uniting Wales, then also Scotland, now the Northern Ireland, the Protestants. Finally, in 1801, Ireland was forcibly incorporated in the United Kingdoms. Now it has become United Kingdoms by incorporating Northern Ireland also in, you can say, a Great Britain. Okay, so a new British nation came into being, which was largely dominated by English culture. It had different cultures previously, Wales, Scotland, now on Northern Ireland, but now it all came to be under one, you can say, everything came, you can say, became one nation, all these regions, and it was dominated by English culture. The symbols of new British, the British flag, the national anthem of the British was God Save Our Noble King. And the English language, they were all promoted, and the older nations were left to survive as the subordinates. Scotland, Ireland and Wales, they were the subordinates of English now. Till now, we have come to know about the rise of nationalism in European countries, various attempts made by the revolutionaries for their right of liberty, establishment of power by the conservatives, and the unification of countries on the basis of various wars we have seen. But when the countries achieved the status of nation state, okay, this was the first aim of these revolutionaries, that there's the concept of nation state, to form nation state. Now, next thing which gained importance was how the country should be visualized. Okay, as we visualize our country, Bharat, in the form of Bharat Mata, actually. Actually, no one has seen Bharat Mata, right? It is just we visualize our country as in the form of Mata, right? We have given it a female figure and we also draw Bharat Mata image and all. We have already studied in, you can say, nationalism in India in that chapter. So now we will, in the next topic, we will be seeing that how the people, they visualize their country. So here in this chart, it is the short revision of the unification of Britain. You can see in 1927 to 1707, this green part, smaller southern part only, it was under Britain. Then here they have shown dark green, Wales, it was incorporated in 1536. Then Scotland in the Act of 1707, the northern part. Then Lordship of Ireland in 11, it was this much, 41 tak. Now, all these different parts, this is, they have shown, okay, these all were different first, but then they all emerged, they were all incorporated into England, the Kingdom of England and Wales first in 1707, okay, this part, now this part has been united. Then Kingdom of Great Britain by incorporating Scotland in it. Then Kingdom of Ireland, this. Otherwise it was smaller, Lordship of Ireland, but then by 18th it became bigger. Then by 1921, Ireland also incorporated in England. It has become Great Britain and Ireland. Then the northern part of Ireland incorporated into Britain. Now it is called the United Kingdom of Great Britain and Northern Ireland. Okay, then the part of which was dominated by Catholics, it is Republic of Ireland or Irish Free State. Okay, so this is how they have shown the unification of Britain. Here this map also shows the same. First this part only, this much, it was England. Then by taking Wales and Scotland, it becomes Great Britain. Then by taking Ireland also in it, it becomes United Kingdom. Okay, the different kingdoms are united. Here England only, here Great Britain. Okay, I hope you have now come to know that why it is called with different names, and the process of unification of Britain is also clear to you. Okay, here the question comes sometimes directly that how England, or you can say the Kingdom of Great Britain, was unified, or why the case of Britain is considered as strange case. You have to focus on the type of question, that how it is asked. If it is asked in this way that why it is strange case, then you start with the same way, that it is called a strange case because it was not the result of sudden revolution, but it was a long process. Then you talk about different cultures which dominated that Ireland. Then you can see the increasing English power, then Act of Union, then Ireland. Okay, so this way you can explain. I hope the concept is clear to you, how it was called Britain, Great Britain, then the United Kingdoms of Great Britain. If you have any doubts, please write to me in the comment section. See you soon in the next video. Take care.